She her mother, amen.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Some other people forgot some things. They forgot the tea and honey. But the Lord bless you. And I know that He still loves you.
Amen.
You got the book of James?
Yes.
The first chapter. And I'll read starting at the first verse. James, a servant of God, of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad. Greetings, my brother, and count it all joy when you fall into divers temptation, knowing this, that the trial of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have a perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. Let's read the third and the fourth verse again together. Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. I want you to use your subject on tonight, just before you sit down. Amen. Look at a neighbor and look from eyeball to eyeball. Find your eyeballs. And say with me, what to do.
What to do.
When your faith is under attack. What to do?
When your faith
is under attack.
Amen.
Go ahead and sit down.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh yeah.
There comes a time where your faith will be under attack.
Amen.
There comes a time where the enemy will try your faith.
Yes.
Some of you are sitting here right now, and there are folk in the church that's trying your faith. Some of you are under attack with folk that just don't like you. And I don't care what you do, they ain't gonna never like you. So you just gotta move on and keep on going. And say, for God I live and for God I die.
Amen.
I want you to know that you can be under attack by the enemy and sometimes not even realize that you're under attack. Many times you wake up in the morning and you feel sluggish, you feel tired, you feel not yourself, you don't seem to look like things are not working right, and you just look at it and say, well, I'm just having a bad day. I just don't feel well today. Well, that's true, but do you understand why you don't feel well today? Do you understand why you just can't seemingly get it together? Sometimes it's because you're under attack. Because of the God that you serve,
yes,
and the living Savior that lives within you, sometimes you're under attack.
Right.
Sometimes folk just don't like the preacher, but sometimes they don't just like you.
Right.
Amen. Amen. And it's not always because something is wrong with you, there's something wrong with them. And because the thing that's in them you don't like what's in you,
right,
then it brings you under attack.
Yes.
How many of you met somebody, and I don't want to be just worded right, amen. How many of you met somebody that just wasn't your favorite person? Hallelujah. You love them with the love of God.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
Amen. But it just turned you the wrong way, and you just can't seem to flow with them. And we got folk like that in the church, I can tell, amen. Sometimes folk just rather not sit by you.
All right.
They sit all the way outside the church. They know where you are. They look at the doctor. They way in the back of the church. Amen. Hallelujah. Try to get away from me. I don't know how they can do that. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But look at somebody saying, what to do?
What to do?
When your faith is under attack.
It's under attack.
Now, when you read the scriptures in the book of James, he said, in that fourth verse, he spoke about patience. So one of the things you need to do when your faith is under attack is to have patience.
Amen.
In God.
Amen.
Hold on to believe God. If God told you something, He's going to do it. If it has not happened yet, just wait on it. It's coming. God is never late. He's always on time. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And so many times your faith is under attack because of the fact that you're dealing with sickness in your body.
Yes.
You're dealing with persecution among people. You're dealing with trials and tribulation. You're dealing with heartaches and trouble. And because of these things that you're dealing with, your faith is under attack. That's why James says, the trying of your faith. This is the trying of your faith. Say that with me. This is the trying, of your faith. The devil will try you every time. Amen. When you look like you're doing well and look like you feel happy, the devil will try your happiness. He will try that joy that you have, and he'll bring something or somebody in your life to take that joy, to steal that joy away from you. But you got to be able to say, this is just a trying of my faith. I got to know what to do when my faith is under attack. When you are under attack, the Bible speaks of being under attack, and your faith mostly can take a hit. But he said, brethren, count it all joy when you fall into what? Divers temptation. The word divers means many temptations. Count it all what?
Joy.
It didn't say it's joy when you're going through something. It didn't say it was joy when you're down and out and feeling sick and hurt and depressed and suppressed. Amen. Obsessed and whatever else you got. Amen. But it says count it as joy. In other words, you got to learn how to make it through. Somebody said fake it till you make it. Well, whatever you got to do, but count it as joy when you go through divers temptation. Knowing this, I said, knowing this, that what? That God said, I'm going to bring you out. And this is just a trial of your faith, and your faith is going to work patience, and patience develops character.
Amen.
I said, patience develops character.
Amen.
Amen. You got to learn how to have patience for some things and deal with some things.
Amen.
Everything's not going to come when you want it. Some of y'all know that already.
Amen.
Some of y'all been trying to be married for the last 30 years. Amen. Patience, my friend.
Amen.
Patience.
Amen.
He said, just forget it. If it takes this long, I don't want it. You just saying you don't want it, you still want it.
Amen.
I'll look at you so they won't end up. Amen. But look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
He going to preach that in a while.
He going to preach that in a while.
I feel y'all getting mad and upset and tripping. Y'all tripping and going on. You better trip somewhere else. Amen. Hallelujah. I got to preach the word of God.
Yeah.
The devil is.
Yeah.
That's right.
Great is he that's in me than he that's in the world.
Hey.
Brother Secretary, the Lord has brought you out. You come a long ways. And you've got nothing but to give God the praise.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody give God a praise right now.
Amen.
I'm almost through. I'm almost through. Amen. Your faith is under attack.
Yes.
Many times the enemy, I told you, will bring sickness. He will bring persecution. He'll bring all kinds of things your way. Amen. To keep you under the attack of the power of the enemy. But that's a song that the old folk used to sing back when I was coming up, and they would sing the song Hallelujah Anyhow.
Right.
Don't let your problems get to that. Something like that. Amen. When life problems come your way, raise your hand to God and say what?
Hallelujah.
Somebody said Hallelujah Anyhow. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We got to learn how to praise God in the midst of what we're going through. The devil is alive. The devil may not be going through or you real nice and like you want it, but you got to say, praise God and bless God anyhow.
Yeah.
I'm going to praise God anyhow. Say that. I'm going to praise God.
I'm going to praise God
anyhow.
Yeah.
I can't let nothing get me down. I can't let the devil stop me.
All right.
But I understand that my faith is under attack.
Yes.
Somebody say attack.
Attack.
What is an attack? An attack is usually means something without warning or surprise.
Yes.
An attack is normally a violent or hostile or aggressive thing. Yes. An attack is of the enemy designed to take you out.
Okay.
And so a lot of times saints, your faith is under attack.
Yes.
Because the devil don't want you to get what God already promised you. And so he'll bring your faith under attack. For the Bible says, I told you, greater is he that is in me than he that is in what?
The world.
The world. Say with me again, the greater one.
The greater one.
Lives within me. The devil says, I thought God said that he was going to heal you. And yet you still feel sick. The devil said, I thought God said that he was going to deliver you. And yet you're bound. The devil said, I thought God said, I will bless you. But you look like you're not blessed. The devil said, I thought God said, I was going to raise you up. But you still seem to be down. The devil said, I thought God said that he would open doors for you. But he seemingly hadn't opened any doors for you. But look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, this is what I do when my faith is under attack. I walk in the ways of the Lord. I trust in the Lord. And the soul said, trust and obey. For there is no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Say, trust and obey.
Trust and obey.
Now, when you decide that I'm going to not let the devil stop me, then the devil's going to try your faith even the more.
Yeah.
And so what the devil does when your faith is under attack, he attacks your peace.
Uh-huh.
You have peace in your life.
Okay.
You're walking in the ways of the Lord. But the devil will come to steal your peace. But I heard the Bible say, I will give them perfect peace.
Uh-huh.
Who mind is staying on me.
Yeah.
The devil then, if he can't take your peace, he'll try your joy and try to rob you of your joy. But the Bible says the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Yeah.
Or can the church help me?
And
somebody shout glory.
Glory.
Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
So if the devil can't take your peace, if the devil can't take your joy, if the devil can't take your strength, if he can't deal with your love, he'll try to take your praise. And that's what he really wants is your praise. Because the praise is about when they go up, the blessing come down. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. I was having a good time the other week. We were in New York the other week. And we're having a good time just enjoying a little 3 or 4 day vacation. But then the devil got in and attacked my knee. And my left knee started hurting. Pain was just, everywhere in my knee. And I was walking with a limp. Hallelujah. And Pastor Nina Tawanda was walking way ahead. The streets of New York,
all right,
yeah. Living, trying to go. I mean, you need a place to stay after church. But I wasn't going to allow the devil to steal my joy that I had being in New York and the fun that I was having being in New York. But many of you would allow pain to rob you of your blessing. But sometimes if you got to hop along, I'll hop along and praise God. I'll hop along and give him the glory. So I can say yes. What to do when your faith is under attack? Brother, count it all joy. Count it all joy. When you go through trials and tribulation, count it all joy. When you go through a situation in your life, you don't know what to do, count it all joy. He said often, weeping may endure for a night. Oh, joy coming in the morning. John said, joy, joy coming in the morning. Shout glory to God. Now I'm just about through, but the Bible says, but let patience have a perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire and want wanting nothing. Now patience said, I'll wait on God.
Yes.
Patience said, I'll wait on God.
Yes.
Even though he told me he was going to do it. And I don't see it happening. I'm going to have patience.
Yes.
See, he said, I waited patiently for it.
Yes.
See, some of y'all are waiting, but you're not waiting patiently.
All right.
You got to wait what?
Patiently.
Yeah. Now I know y'all can preach the message better than I can. But since I got the flow, you might as well say amen.
Yeah. Come on, Pat. Come on.
When your faith is under attack, the devil will try your patience. And he said, I'm tired of waiting on God. I'm tired of waiting on what God told me he was going to do.
All right.
And I'm just wondering, is God going to do what he said he was going to do?
Yes.
Have you ever really felt that way before?
Yes.
Have God ever told you, I'm going to do something?
Yes.
I'm going to make a way.
Yes.
I'm going to open a door.
Yes.
I'm going to bless you.
Well,
you've been waiting and waiting and waiting. You can't seem to see the blessing.
Yes.
That's just your faith under attack. The devil tried to steal my joy when the pain got in my knee. But what did I do? I said, I'm going to fight this thing. Y'all know me, I'm just silly. Hallelujah. And I had the pain. And I started walking like this. And it wasn't that bad, but then, man, I'm making fun to the devil.
All right.
You're a lying devil.
All right.
You're going to try to make me feel bad.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. faith. Abraham was the father of faith. And he said, God, I believe you. And whatever you tell me, I stand on your word. And God spoke to Abraham and said, hey, Abraham, he said, I want you to take your son and put him on the altar. And put him on the altar. And I want you to take your knife and take your son's life. Make him a sacrifice unto me.
Yeah.
stop it. Now that pain that I had in my knee is gone.